So, for my birthday this year, I decided to make myself a present. But I'm getting ahead of myself, so let's rewind. You see, I'm a papercraft artist and I've worked with companies like Lucasfilm, Disney, and others. But I decided I wanted to make a project just for me. I'm a huge fan of classic arcade games, and Joust is probably my all-time favorite. This game took the world by storm in 1982. Players take the role of a knight riding on a flying ostrich. They're tasked with defeating hordes of enemy knights riding on buzzards, and it was one of the first games to feature cooperative two-player gameplay. Joust was a huge commercial success, grossing over $80 million in quarters. And a lot of those quarters were mine. So for a while now, I've had this idea to combine my love of papercraft and pixel art, making an art piece to honor the Yellow Knight. Inspiration struck, and there were two things that I wanted to accomplish to make this really unique. My first big idea was that I didn't want to just cut a bunch of square pixels and slap them together. I wanted to try and emulate the horizontal scan lines of old TVs. Those cathode ray tube TVs created pictures by scanning an electron beam across the screen in horizontal lines. And I thought it would be fun to capture the feeling of this technology in my art. So my paper pixels are actually hand-cut bars of black foam core. This foam core edge isn't as dark as I'd like it to be, but a Sharpie will fix that. And I like using glue sticks for this part to keep the mess down. My second big idea was not to stop at a single layer for my paper pixel project. So let's keep building the pixels up. By making things more 3D, I think it breathes more life and action into the art. Even with no color, it looks pretty cool. But let's add some color. I've had these paint chips from the hardware store laying around for a long time, so let's recycle them for this project. Just like my foam core pieces, I lightly glued a grid onto the paint chips so that I could cut them out exactly right, and then it's like making a colorful puzzle. I will say this part took a long time, and I'm already thinking of 3 or 4 ways I might do this differently in the future. One more paper pixel left, and the Yellow Knight lives. But dang, I must have had a lot of glue on my fingers, because this mat looks messy. No worries, just grab some isopropyl alcohol, and with a slightly moistened paper towel, lightly rub away the gluey mess. Less is more here. Don't use a lot of liquid, and don't use much pressure. That's more like it. I cut this mat board to a very specific size because I knew I was going to use it in this frame that I got from my local Michael's craft store. Ah, this workplace is a mess. Let's clean this up. The frame I'm using is actually a display case, or a shadow box if you'd rather call it that. And it's no accident that the 3D layers of my paper pixel project will fit perfectly inside because I measured this carefully before I started. And the edge of this glass can cut you, so be careful with that too. So, let's put this thing back together and see how it looks. Yes, that's it. It's capturing all of the emotions and the feels of classic Joust. I love it. But I want to know, what video game character would you hang on your wall? And why is it your favorite? Let me know in the comments below.